everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV, brought to you by Adorama. It's the camera store that has everything for photographers like you and me, including these groovy NAND lights. So this right here is a LED light. It's the PAVOTUBE 15C. I've never used one of these before, but I'm in my friend Fede's studio here in Buenos Aires, Argentina, and he had some of these, and he said I could play with them, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do. I've got this really groovy setup over here I'm gonna show you in just a little bit, but first, let me show you why these are gonna be really interesting. So, it's a normal LED light that you can use for video, but you can also use these for stills. And this has a little thing here, you can dim it if you want, you can change the color temperature to make it bright or dim, whatever color temperature you want. But the other thing you can do, this has got all kinds of different modes. So I can click this little button here, and now I can change this to any kind of lightsabery color that I want. And that is really cool. So what I'm gonna do is first, I'm gonna make a really nice beauty light setup using three of these in a triangular configuration to sort of rip off Peter Hurley, one of my friends, and make some really interesting catch lights in our model's eyes. And then we'll use this in the background to sort of separate the background. And then after that's done, once we have a shot that's awesome, then we'll zip over and start playing with all these colors and see what we can create. So now that you know about this light and how it works, let's get a model in and I'll walk you through the setup. Our model has arrived, it's Juana! And so let me walk you back here and show you exactly how I have things set up. We have four lights, there are four lights for you Star Trek fans. And so this first light here, we're just illuminating this black background. And so that's going to make sure that she doesn't just sink into oblivion with her dark hair. We can change the luminosity and maybe even the color of this to get some really interesting effects. The star of the show, though, are these three lights. So I'll turn these on, one, two, three. And this is in a triangle, a little pyramid shape, and we're shooting through that. So Peter Hurley style, I'm gonna be shooting really nice and close on Juana. And because these three lights are set up the way they are, it's going to surround Juana's face to have sort of this shadowless light. And because it's this triangle, that is going to show up in her eyes, those reflections, those catch lights, and give us that really cool sci-fi look that I really love. So we're gonna move the camera around to this side so you can see through this and see exactly what I'm talking about. We've moved the video camera so you can see this at a different angle to get a better understanding of how this is working here. But before we show you a little bit more about the lights, let me first talk about what I'm doing with my camera. So I'm shooting with the 50 millimeter lens at 1.4, so wide open. That's something you can do with constant light because they're not as bright as a studio strobe. And so you can open up that aperture. It's one of the things I really love. Now, because of that, the depth of field is going to be incredibly shallow. So if my camera moves back and forth or if Juana moves back and forth, things are going to fall out of focus. So to prevent me from doing that, I'm going to put my camera on a tripod to lock that down so it's not moving back and forth. That's just going to help me with my focus. I'm also shooting an ISO of 200 because even these at full blast, they're not as bright as I need them to be if I'm gonna have my shutter speed fast enough to freeze motion. So my shutter speed is about 1/125th of a second, so I'll play with that as we go along, but just fast enough so that I don't have any camera shake or any movement showing up in those shots. Okay, let's talk a little bit about how I've set these lights. Now we can set two things in this mode on these lights. The first one is the color temperature. So I've set these all at 5,000 Kelvin. And so then I set the white balance on my camera to match 5,000 Kelvin. And then I have them at full luminosity, so they're as bright as they can get. We're not gonna mess with any of the colors on this first setup because we just want a nice, clean beauty shot. There is one thing that we really have to pay attention to though, that's back here. We have this separation light and it is hidden behind Juana. Now if Juana moves, so Juana izquierda y derecha, see if she moves to the left or to the right, this light is gonna show up and that's gonna give us problems. So I'm gonna have to really make sure that I direct her to stand in the right place so that everything works out. Before we start, there's one more thing I need to mention and that is ambient light. So if you're working with studio strobes, you can always get rid of the ambient light by stopping down your aperture and shooting at sync speed. So usually you're shooting at ISO 100 in an aperture of 8 or something. So ambient light just doesn't really impact the photos. But if you're shooting with always on light like this, well, that is ambient light. And so you have to be really peculiar about the lights that are on in your studio. We have two video lights going on right now to help us make this video. We've got another one back here lighting up the wall. We've got computer monitors on. We've got some window light. All of that has to be eliminated to make sure it doesn't pollute this. So when you're in your studio, remember to make sure you turn off everything that you don't want to show up in your shots. All right, now that we know that, we can start. We've got our first shot with the triangle. Now it's time to play and just have some fun with color. And so what I did here is I rearranged these lights. And the first thing I did was over here, this is from the original triangle setup. This is left at 5,000 Kelvin. So I didn't change the color temperature. The color temp on the camera is also at 5,000 Kelvin, but I lowered the luminosity, how bright this is, all the way down to about 25%. So it's much less bright than it was before. It's just giving us some sort of natural color on Wana. This guy here, I made it a crazy blue color just so I can illuminate the side of Wana's face. This is a green. This is going to give us some sheen on Wana's hair. And then back here, full blast, we have this red going on the background. And the camera is changed a little bit. So now I am shooting at a 60th of a second at ISO 200. And so that's gonna give us a little bit of motion blur. I'm still shooting at 1.4, so that is gonna make our depth of field super shallow. So focus is always gonna be an issue at 1.4, but we're gonna try to induce some motion to create some fun. So Wana has been spinning around, so por favor, spin. So she's doing that, and with the 60th of a second, her hair starts making these crazy trails. It looks almost like we did it in post-production. Let me mention one more thing. We have some of these lights that are in the frame of my shot. So I'm using live view here to see that. And my lens hood is off my lens. So we're getting some of this lens flare. That's just adding to that colory fun effect. So now Wana's gonna spin around. So listo? Okay, por favor, spin. Thank you, Wana. This was so much fun. We got to set up our NAND lights and get a really nice headshot that had some awesome specular highlights. But then just changing the colors and mixing things up, we got to have some sort of crazy fun. And that's what photography is all about. Lots of smiles and having fun in the studio. Thanks to Fede, who's behind the camera right there. This is his gear, his studio here in Buenos Aires. We're still in quarantine. And so getting around and getting stuff can be difficult sometimes. And so Fede has really helped us out. And so I've included links to Fede's stuff and links to Wana's stuff in the description of this video. So you might want to check that out. It's all good. Thanks so much for joining us. Don't forget to subscribe because there's tons of free stuff coming at you every single day. Turn on the bell so you get notifications. You don't want to miss on the live broadcast, all those live streams that we're doing because they are really amazing. So thanks so much and I will see you again next time.